This is the gifted actress and star of stage and screen, lovely Olivia de Havilland.
Thank you. This is my partner, John Marsh, from Deerfield, Illinois.
This is the talented motion picture actor currently starring in The Trial, Anthony Perkins.
Hello. This is my partner, Chris Danielenko, from Maspeth, New York. And we're all here to play Password.
Yes, it's Password, brought to you this evening by... And now, here's your host on Password, Alan Ludden.
Hi, Dal.
Well, good evening. Very nice to have you with us. How are you, Tony?
Fine.
Good to see you. Olivia de Havilland, what a pleasure to have you back.
How nice of you to say that.
And you've been to Hollywood for the first time in 6 years to
yes,
make a movie.
I have, that's true.
And it's a wonderful movie. Tell us about it, will you? What's it called?
It's called Lady in a Cage, and it's a suspense story about a woman who is trapped in a private elevator in her own house.
And who else is in it with you?
Lots of interesting and talented people. One who will mean a great deal to you is Ann Southern.
Ann Southern, a real good friend. Wonderful movie, Lady in a Cage, Olivia de Havilland's first Hollywood movie in 6 years. Nice to have you here. Your first partner is John Marsh, Olivia.
Yes.
From Deerfield, Illinois. What do you do for a living, John?
I'm in a sales training program with a brokerage house in New York.
Well, I'm glad you're here to play Password.
Thank you.
Tony, I don't want to be personal or anything, but I have a very fine barber that I'd like to introduce you to. Now, tell us why. Why the haircut?
Well, I'm about to start a picture called The Fool Killer, and it takes place in the time of the Civil War, and that's just the way they wore their hair those days.
Yeah, you'd be pretty hip in the Civil War days. You look great. It's good to have you back.
Thanks.
Your first partner is Chris Danielenko?
Yes.
Oh, you had trouble with it.
I did.
I got through it, and you had trouble
with it. I know. You're a senior in high school, though, Chris. I know that.
Yes.
What do you plan to do when you graduate?
I want to major in business administration, but minor in theater arts.
Fine. Well, I'm glad you're going to play Password. You know how we play it? It's a game of word communication where you try to make your partner say the password by using one-word clues. Both teams work on the same password at the same time, and the team that gets it first is the one that scores. I'll give the first password this evening to the star of Lady in the Cage, star of the upcoming Fool Killer, Tony Perkins, and as they look at it, we'd like you to see it.
The password is beach.
Start with you, Tony. 10 points.
Sandy.
Beach.
Yes! One minute. First word, go.
Grizzly.
Bear.
50.
Shoes.
Socks.
100.
Plane.
Air.
Super.
Jet.
150.
Leg.
Slow.
Sleeve.
Fall.
Sleeve.
Sleeve. Arm.
Yes.
Sticky.
Gooey.
Paste.
Sticky.
Paste.
Glue.
Yes.
All right. By golly, we've had some good lightning rounds tonight. You realize everybody's gotten the maximum. Kathleen, you have 250 plus 250. Kathleen Erickson has $500, and Tony Perkins won a game. Paul Heffler, you will have the World Book Encyclopedia. We'll be back in a minute to tell you about next week's guest stars on Password, but right now, you know, there's more to building a highway than meets the eye. Watch.
I don't know if you can see. I don't know if you can see me. It's so bright out here. I can't tell. Anyway, let's see here. And the bugs are everywhere. See that? That's the flower of the yucca plant. A yucca bush, yucca plant. Can you see it in the background there? Anyway, I just wanted to show you this yucca because they only bloom every other year. And happens to be this year. And what's odd to me is that they don't bloom every year. You know, some plants bloom every other year, but they all seem to bloom at the same time every other year. But they're pretty cool. They I like the flowers because they look almost good enough to eat, but I usually see I see a lot of ants crawling up the stalks, you know, if you get close to them. So somebody likes them. I guess the bees probably do too. But anyway, I just wanted to show you how tall they are too. I'm nearly 7 feet tall, and they are quite a bit taller than that. We had a, when I lived in Hollywood, we had a century plant that blooms every 100 years, and it just so happened to bloom at the time we were living there, and it shoots up a very tall stalk, like, oh gosh, 20 feet maybe. Blooms, I forget what kind of flowers, but the rest of the 99 years, the leaves on the bottom are very solid, substantial, like succulent. And they have, what do they call, needles on the very end, like a syringe needle, like at the doctor. And so we had to cut those tips off because if you just accidentally brushed by, you would just cut yourself and get some kind of cactus infection, I'm sure. I don't know. But anyway, they were pretty cool. And we were lucky to see it that year we were there. So I'm going to get out of the way here for a minute and let you look at it again. And then I'm going to tell you about the story I took, mini road trip I took, I think last Saturday. I went up north to see the giant sequoia trees, which I'm going to tell you about or show you how to get there in this video. So hold on, I'll be right back. So here's the little seed pod, and those are the green ones, and on this other stalk, see, they dry up and open up and gets full out somewhere, and it's amazing there isn't a whole field here, but I'm in a creek bed, a river bed actually, and it took hold in the rock somehow. So well, that's it about the yucca. I just wanted to share real quick that I took a drive up to the giant sequoia trees. I don't know if you can see me. Giant sequoia trees, it's the southernmost grove in California, and it's northeast of Los Angeles and northeast of Bakersfield. Way there that says there's 100 giants. Well, when I went up, somebody asked me, well, did you see all 100 of them? And I said, oh gosh, that's right. No, I think I only counted 5. I wasn't really counting. I was just trying to find a place that was quiet because there was a lot of activity up there by the forest crew, I guess. They were felling logs. Chainsaws and So that was pretty noisy, but the tall trees are still there, of course. I think they must be, what, 1,000, 2,000 years old, but they're just amazing. They're incredible. And if you get a chance to take a break, take a drive and go up there, I'll leave you clues here with road signs and put directions on, if not this video, on my blog. I drove about, I think it was 300 miles round trip, and I'm in Lancaster, about 60 miles north of Los Angeles. So it was a nice long day, about 10 hours. And it would have been 11 hours if I would have stopped. I did that years ago, about 20 years ago when I went up there. There's a natural hot springs. If when I go in a loop and I come back the other side, toward Ducor, D-U-C-O-R. There's a natural hot spring, swimming pool, and spas there, and that's pretty cool, especially in the winter. That's nice to just sit and soak. Oh, man. Hot out here today. It's like 90 degrees, but I just wanted to kind of sort of start and finish with some plants on this video to show you one of my favorite things, like the redwood trees further up north on the coast. These are the giant sequoias. I think they're shorter and fatter, or stockier, I should say, but they're still pretty tall. And I had a good time. I did find a quiet spot up there. The smells were just outstanding. I absolutely love that. And they turned the chainsaws off for a while there, and so I found a bench and I sat there and I could hear the birds and took a few deep breaths, and then that was it. But what was I going to say? Oh, when I came back real quick, and it was just after dark, about 8 p.m., and there was some guy rummaging through our the dumpster in our apartment building, and I'm all for that. I don't mind that at all, and I really respect their tenacity and integrity to get practically inside the dumpster into every bag and just, you know, get what they can get to recycle and keep it out of the landfill. And it reminded me of, you know, the efforts that I made at my last job that I still haven't told you about, that I recycled every piece of paper that came through my department. I was in document control or records management, so there was a lot of paper, and I would save up boxes of paper for months, and then maybe twice a year, three times a year, I would load up my pickup and take it to the recycler. And I only made about $200 over the year, but I recycled at least a ton of paper that would have otherwise gone into the landfill. So it was a habit that once I started, I could never stop, and I had worked there for 20 years, so it felt good. And people at work knew that I recycled anything and everything, so they would end up bringing stuff from home sometimes, like magazines and newspapers, and, "Jack, I don't know how to recycle this. Can you help me? What can you do?" "I'll take it. I can't say no." Well, here's a cool rock. Look at this. Granite of some kind. All right, well, that's it. My knees are locking into place here. I don't know if I can stand up. I'm going to try. I'll give you one more look at the yucca plant here before I sign off. Okay, keep it clean and keep it green. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye. Oh, and check out these larger-than-life pine cones I just found over here by this, well, it's a pine tree. I don't know if it's a coastal pine or what, but that is humongous. A lot of pine nuts in there, I'll bet, huh? All right, enjoy the yucca treat. Well, actually, I'll take you up close and personal. You can see those flowers better, okay? Here we go. See, there's the spindly. These are very sharp. Very sharp. Ouch. Here's the flowers. Look at that. Cool. All right. Had enough? Yep. I like them because they're tall, I guess. Huh? So here's that pine tree. Big. Wind blowing, it sounds good out here. All right, I'm gonna sign off because I don't think you can hear me anyway in all this wind. Bye. See ya.